Hi friends, now I'm discussing up the microbiology questions of the Jipmer. Fine, the recent ones. The first question is knot infection is not seen in, and the options are H. nana, H. diaminata, strongyloids, and tenia solium. So this you already know that what is the mnemonic for this? The mnemonic for this is chest. Okay. This is a well-known mnemonic. I've already told up in the notes and all that chest is the mnemonic for auto infection. These are the fellows which shows the auto infection. So this particular is C square, and this C is what? This C is Capillaria filipensis. Okay. This particular C is what? Capillaria filipensis. Then another C is what? Cryptosporidium parvum. Okay, Cryptosporidium parvum. H is H. nana. E is Entrobius vermicularis. Okay, S is Strongyloids stercoralis. And T is Tenia solium. Okay. So these are the fellows which undergo auto infection. So this is very clear that the answer would be what? The answer would be H. diaminata. So beware of these types of things. This H you need to remember stands for what? It stands for H. nana, not H. diaminata. And what is H. diaminata? That is actually the rat tapeworm. It is actually the rat tapeworm, which is termed as diaminata. So this doesn't shows the auto infection. There's a H. nana, which is also termed as dwarf tapeworm. It shows auto infection. Strongyloids stercoralis, you know, it shows auto infection. Okay. And this particular Strongyloids stercoralis, can you tell me this one is more common in whom? In the immunosuppressed fellows and mostly in the HIV positive. Strongyloids stercoralis infection is very common. Regarding the Tenia solium, what you need to remember, Tenia solium is a armed tapeworm, and the larval form of this is what? Cysticercus cellulosae. That you also need to remember, right? Regarding the Cryptosporidium parvum, the favorite of the examiners nowadays, 4 to 6 micronucleus, and the drug of choice in HIV positive fellows for this is nitazoxanide, and the brothers of it, Cyclospora, Isospora, that also you need to remember. They are also coccinium parasites, and the size of them for the Cyclospora is 8 to 12 or 8 to 10 micron, and for the Isospora is 23-36 micron. And they have become very important because they cause diarrhea in the HIV positive fellows. And the question of last All India was that what is the drug of choice for Cyclospora and Isospora? The answer is Cotrimoxazole. Okay. Regarding the H. nana. Regarding the H. nana, you remember the egg of this is having hooklets. Okay, it is having the central hooklets, and on both the sides there is a polar thickening of polar filaments which you see, and this is a non-bile stained egg, and that you know that what is non-bile stained eggs? Neha, fine. And what is in the Neha? That is Nicator americanus, Entrobius vermicularis, okay, H. nana, and Ankylostoma duodenale. Okay. So those are non-bile stained eggs, and rest of all others are what? Bile stained. Entrobius vermicularis. Regarding this particular fellow, you remember one thing, that this is also termed as seed worm, thread worm, or pin worm. Okay, and this is common in the children and associated with perianal pruritus, that you already know. And for this, we do a swabbing, that is termed as NIH swab, that is National Institute Health swab, which is a rod with a cellophane tape. Tenia solium, I have already told you, and Capillaria filipensis is also a nematode, and this also shows auto infection. Fine. So answer to this question is B. Now the smallest element among the following is, let's see that what is the various sizes of different elements given in the option. So H. nana, I have already told you the other name of this is dwarf tapeworm. And it is smallest stored with the added length of how much? 15 to 44 mm only. Diameter is having in centimeters, that is 20 to 60, and obviously I have told you it is a rat tape form. The trophozoite is oval in the case of Mantidium coli and approximately 50 to 100 microns and 40 to 70 micron wide. And D-latum is 30 feet, and obviously this is the longest here. A D-latum is actually what? Divalobothrium latum, or termed as fish tapeworm. So the answer is very obvious. The answer is H. nana. Okay. Now this infection, that is tungiasis. Tungiasis is what actually? So let's see what is tungiasis. So tungiasis is a inflammatory skin disease. First thing, it is caused by the infection with a female ectoparasite, that is Tunga penetrans. This is a less known name, but remember up if it is being asked once, can be asked again. Also termed as Chigo flea, Chigger, okay, Nigua, and Sand flea. These are the various names. No need to remember one name. You remember, that is a Tunga penetrans. That is already a slight bit difficult. Okay, it is found in Africa, it is found in the Caribbean, it is found in the Central and South America, and in India also. That's why we are reading it. Tunga penetrans is the smallest known flea, measuring only how much? 1 mm across. And it causes what? Skin inflammation, pain, itching, lesion at the site of infection, which is characterized by what? Black dot at the center of the swollen red lesion, surrounded by what looks like a white halo. Okay. Center of a swollen red lesion and surrounded by what looks like a white halo. White halo is there on. So this is what is tungiasis. So basically it's an ectoparasitic infection of the skin by the Tunga penetrans. So answer is ectoparasitic infection, skin one. The answer is A. Now the gold standard investigation for Zika virus. What is the gold standard investigation for Zika virus? So in this, they have given up two options. One is PCR and one is real-time PCR. So obviously, real-time or reverse transcriptase PCR. So answer to this question will be D, because this is a RNA virus. So answer would be RT-PCR here. Okay. And this Zika, as such, belongs to which particular family? It belongs to arbovirus. This is a arbovirus. And in the arbo also, it belongs to which one? It is Flaviviridae member. Okay. It is a Flaviviridae member, and recently in Jaipur, the Zika epidemic have happened, a sort of epidemic, and the foreigners obviously they have brought it up. How does this particular infection transmit? This transmits with the help of a mosquito that is termed as Aedes, which was asked in the Kaun Banega Crorepati also. So one is Aedes and another one is what? Sexual transmission. Okay, another one is what? Sexual transmission. So sexual transmission in Aedes, that transmits the Zika virus, and this particular one associates with fever, a maculopapular rash, and even myalgia and all. These are the features in the infection of Zika, right? And the importance of Zika is there in the pregnancy. And if a pregnant female gets the infection of Zika, okay, if a pregnant female gets the infection of Zika virus, then the newborn tends to develop two important things. One is microcephaly and GBS. Microcephaly and GBS. So this also need to remember. What is GBS? Guillain-Barré syndrome. Okay. And the investigation of choice, gold standard, is RT-PCR. Now the fifth question is the gene responsible for the semi-synthetic penicillin resistance in the Staph aureus. Obviously the answer is MAC-A. And the main mechanism of MRSA is, the main mechanism for this is PBP changes to PBP2A. And what is PBP? Penicillin binding protein. Penicillin binding protein. That is the name of the PBP. Penicillin binding protein. Okay. The other name of penicillin binding protein is transpeptidase. So there is a alteration in the transpeptidase, and because of this alteration, which is mostly chromosomal, with the help of which gene it happened? MAC-A gene. They have acquired from somewhere this MAC-A gene, and they have changed their outer surface from PBP to what? PBP2A. This is there. Okay. Then you can remember This is one of the mechanisms. Other mechanisms are production of beta-lactamases, production of penicillinases, which is also a type of a beta-lactamase. They are also the mechanism of MRSA. What is the drug of choice for this? Drug of choice is Venco, and the syndrome associated with Redman syndrome with the Venco. And as for the microbiology is concerned, in this you need to remember that you do two types of screening tests. One is cefoxitin and one is oxacillin, and obviously which is better? Cefoxitin screening test is better. Okay, so that is there in this particular one. Penton valentine leukocidin is produced by, so this is also simple, answer is D, that is the staph aureus does it. And the staph aureus which is there, the staph aureus which is there, okay, the answer to this question is staph aureus. Just want to change the color of it. Okay, the staph aureus, penton valentine leukocidin, this is PV toxin which is also termed as leukocidin, which kills the leukocytes along with gamma hemolysin, along with gamma hemolysin. This particular combination is termed as synergohematotropic action. This particular thing is termed as what? Synergohematotropic action. When this PV toxin mixes up with gamma hemolysin and it produces a synergy, which is termed as synergohematotropic action. Okay, what is the meaning of this? That they work in synergy, and when they work in synergy, there is an increase in the virulence of staph aureus. There is an increase in the virulence of staph aureus. So this you need to remember. Can you tell me some other virulence factors of this? So obviously you know that, that is clumping factor, protein A, alpha hemolysin, beta hemolysin. Okay, these are the important ones. Other than that, this penton valentine leukocidin, along with that the enzymes, various enzymes are there. One of them, the most important, is coagulase. Okay, which of the following is the amplifying host for the Japanese encephalitis? So this you already know that JE virus belongs to which family? Arbovirus. Again, so Japanese encephalitis is caused by Japanese encephalitis virus, and the reservoirs here, the reservoirs here is ardent birds, and ardent birds are actually the cranes, egrets. These all, they are the reservoirs of this particular Japanese encephalitis. Okay, then what are the amplifiers here? The amplifiers here is pig. Pigs are the amplifiers here in the case of J, and the transmitter of this disease is the mosquito Culex. And which particular mosquito? Culex vishnoi. It is in India, and Culex tritinuranicus. Okay, Culex tritinuranicus, that is in the world. So this also need to remember. What they can give? They can give a picture and they can show the birds, pigs, and the mosquito along with the men, and they can ask which disease. So that is Japanese encephalitis. So answer to this is A, that is the pigs. Okay, then the trans ovarian transmission is seen among. So first of all, we should see what is trans ovarian transmission. So trans ovarian transmission is occurring in the arthropod vectors. Remember this, which transmits pathogens from the parent arthropod to the offspring arthropod. Okay, so basically what it is a vertical transmission, and it is instantly and best shown by which fellow? Rickettsia rickettsii. And what does it cause? It causes Rocky Mountain spotted fever, the famous disease which you know. So this particular like rickettsial member, it is carried within the ticks because the ticks transmits it. Okay, and it is passed from parent to offspring by the transovarial transmission. One thing. Okay, and this transovarial transmission is also seen in the Aedes mosquito vector, the yellow fever, and this particular one, that is phlebotomous one, phlebotomine sandflies, that transmits this particular fever, that is the Papatasi fever. So all these fellows, the Rickettsia rickettsii, this particular Aedes mosquito, and this particular sandfly, that is phlebotomy, sandfly, which transmits this fever, they all show transovarial transmission. So basically, in more fine words, it is vertical transmission. The transtadial transmission. This particular transtadial is another transmission which you need to remember. When a pathogen remains within the vector from one life stage, that is the stadium also to call it, to the next, means there is not from adults to the new ones. It is from one life stage to the another one. So that is termed as transtadial transmission. And the bacteria involved is what? Borrelia burgdorferi. Okay. This shows transtadial transmission. And what does it cause? It causes Lyme disease. That also you know. Okay. And Lyme disease is not in India. It's an American disease which have erythema chronicum migrans. Along with that is, you need to remember what is the other name of it? Bull's eye lesion. Okay. And you know that what is the vector of it? The vector is tick, which as a larva infects the tick vector as a larva, this particular one, Borrelia burgdorferi. Okay. And the infection is maintained in this when it molts to nymph and later develops as an adult. So this is what is there. The infects the tick vector as a larva, and the infection is maintained when it molts to nymph and later develops as an adult. So basically it's a in the life cycle. This particular one is in the life cycle, and this type of transmission is seen in some viruses and the rickettsial family members. Okay. In this particular one, this option is wrong. That is coccidioidomyces. Actually, this option is Cyclospora. Cyclospora catinensis. So the ninth one, the retroviral positive patients present with frequent diarrhea. The stool examination reveals acid fast oocyst of size 8 to 10 micron. What could be the probable diagnosis? So to this particular one, you remember Toxoplasma gondii, it can't be. Cryptosporidium pauma is 4 to 6 micron. This is the only one which is 8 to 10 or 8 to 12 micron. Okay. So, and in HIV positive. I already told you that these fellows, all they are having oocyst, which are having their size, and this is the acid fast oocyst size. And all of acid fast means are, they are pink in color. So these all pink in color, and according to that, you will give the medications. Okay. In a HIV positive fellow. So answer to this question is actually C, and this is not coccidioidosis. This is actually the Cyclospora. Okay. The uncrusted cystitis. The uncrusted cystitis is caused by Cornibacterium urolyticum. Okay. Cornibacterium urolyticum, it is causing up the uncrusted cystitis. How it is? Because this urolyticum, as the name suggests, it is urease positive. It produces ammonia, and because of that, these things, that is cystitis, pyelitis, these all things, they happen. So actually this is because of this particular urease formation, because it produces this urease and it have an action, it produces ammonia and leads to this crustacean formation, which is also termed as what? Uncrusted cystitis. Actually this urolyticum is what? Urolyticum is a normal skin commensal, but sometimes while doing interventions inside the body, like you're putting up catheter and all, these fellows also go and they cause this cystitis and all. Okay. The alic gel precipitation test is used for. So this everybody knows, answer is Cornibacterium diphtheriae. Okay. Remember one more thing which can come here. The alic gel precipitation test is which type of precipitation. So remember, this is a double diffusion in two dimension. This particular thing is what? Double diffusion in two dimensions. This is what is alic gel precipitation test. Double diffusion in two dimension. Okay. The other name of the same thing is Ochterlony. The other name of the same thing is Ochterlony, because this is also double diffusion in two dimensions. Okay. So basically it's a toxin antitoxin action. Okay. Double diffusion, toxin antitoxin, both are moving and in different directions. That is termed as two dimension. That is Ochterlony. Cornibacterium diphtheriae. Diphtheria is toxemia, not bacteremia. Okay, it is having a bull neck. The complications is also important of it. That is myocarditis and polyneuropathy, which is more complicated stuff. Answer is myocarditis, because it is carrying mortality also. Then there is a tagline here, that every CD is not pathogenic. It is made pathogenic by what? That is the beta phage carrying a toxin. And this conversion from the beta phage is termed as what? Lysogenic conversion. Okay. Another point which was asked in the AIMS exam, that how does the toxin acts? How does the exotoxin acts of it? So answer is, it does ADP ribosylation of elongation factor, which inhibits the protein synthesis. Which arrangement it have? Cuneiform or Chinese letter pattern. What are the biotypes? Gravis, intermedius, mitis. Okay. Daisies, frog eggs are poached. That is the appearance of them on the culture media, that is potassium tellurate agar. Which is used for the early diagnosis? Answer is Loeffler serum slope. What is the most common location for the membrane formation, pseudomembrane? Answer is fossil. Which is the most dangerous? That is the laryngeal. Okay. What are the various non-concomitant diphtheria important? So one I have to told you, that is one PABM, which acts as an immunomodulator. And another very important with the skin question is myotonicum leads to erythrasma. And now, just now we have seen Cornibacterium urolyticum, which also causes what? Uncrusted cystitis. Okay. So this also you need to remember. Which of the following is a cocoa waistline? For this particular one, I made a mnemonic. That is the Lady Harding College really looks beautiful always. Okay. So Legionella. So that you know Legionella. Legionella is a gram negative cocoa waistline. And Legionella is associated. Whenever you talk about Legionella, you have to talk about what? Centralized EC. Simple. And it leads to pontine fever, pneumophila, and it also leads to a Legionella's pneumonia, which is an atypical pneumonia, but it shows most of the features of what? A typical pneumonia. This is also a point. Then the culture media is BCYE and drug of choice for macrolides. Then in the Harding, H stands for Haemophilus and Helicobacter. Haemophilus, influenza, if you talk about, that is capsulated, non-capsulated both. Capsulated are more virulent, and satellitism you need to remember in that. Helicobacter, you remember this is strongest urease positive. It produces immense amount of urease enzyme which converts into the ammonia. And it leads to three important things, that is PUD, maltomas and carcinoma stomach. Remember one important aspect here, the CAG and VAC containing genes, fellows, they will cause more of a problem. Okay. They will carry more virulence in the case of Helicobacter pylori. Campylobacter, Gull-wing-shaped bacteria, and this particular Gull-wing-shaped bacteria, the full name Campylobacter jejuni, which loves to grow at 42 degrees centigrade, is a Gull-wing one, and important that in children it can cause GBS, Guillain-Barré syndrome. And what about the virus? That is the Zika, which you need to remember. Okay. Regarding the chlamydia exists in two forms, extracellular elementary body, intracellular reticulate body. Trachomatis is the most important fellow. ABBAC leads to trachoma, D2K leads to a number of things like inclusion conjunctivitis, genital chlamydiasis, and infantile pneumonia. L1, L2, L3 leads to LGV. Incubation period of LGV, that is around 3 to 30. That will be the better answer. And which type of body is a senior cytokinesis? That is Leventhal corn lily. And what about trachoma? You see Halbert provosic bodies. And what about Henderson Peterson? They are seen in molluscan contagiosum. Right? Regarding the rickettsia, this is a whole family. We have already know the rickettsia type and all that stuff, what they cause and what they're there. So this you need to remember. The drug of choice for rickettsia family is doxy. An important question. Scrub typhus is becoming day by day famous for every exam period is coming up. And it has been caused by what? Orange susugamosi, that you already know. And which wheel felix test is positive in that? That is the OXK. OXK antigen is strongly positive for that particular one. Listeria. This is the only one here which is a gram positive cocoa bacilli. Regarding listeria, it causes in the newborn granulomatosis and infantiseptica. And the drug of choice for this condition is ampicillin. And remember the Lisa auntie also. That is Anton test is seen in listeria. Then beautiful B is Brucella. Okay, this is not Brucellosis, this is Brucella. Brucella leads to brucellosis, and brucellosis is a genotic disease. Various ones, that is, it infects the milk and all. So that is there, acute brucellosis, undulant fever, Malta fever, Mediterranean fever, all this is there in brucellosis. And remember those tests for this, like particular milk contamination. Rose Bengal card test, milk ring test, whey agglutination test. You remember that rose card and the ring. You have to think of Brucella also. And the drug of choice of Brucella is what? The drug of choice of brucellosis is doxy, along with Rifa. And some books they write strepto also. Bordetella pertussis. Bordetella pertussis leads to pertussis, as the name suggests. And the media also comes from this. That is the bonded Ganju media. Okay. And the drug of choice for this is macrolides. Other than that, catarrhal, paroxysmal, and convulsion. These are the phases which are seen in this pertussis one. And there used to be done a blunder before in the investigation that was termed as cuff plate method. Now it is not there. Acinetobacter, that is always Acinetobacter. Acinetobacter is a gram negative cocoa bacilli belonging to non-fermenting groups, and it is becoming day by important. And the important species of it which is there is this one, that is Acinetobacter baumani. And this baumani is an MDR isolate of ISU, and it leads to number of ailments nowadays, and it is mostly found to be MDR1. Okay. 14th question. Which of the following is a bile alkaline positive and shows 6.5% sodium chloride positivity? The answer to this question is Enterococcus faecalis, because it shows a growth in 6.5% NaCl, and it's a type of naughty bacteria. It resists 6.5% NaCl, it grows in that, it resists 40% bile, it resists a pH of 9.4, and it can manage a temperature of 45, 55 or even 60 for some minutes. So this is an atypical bacteria as such, but still it belongs to group D, and that is a controversial one. And what is the drug of choice for this? That is the penicillin along with aminoglycoside, which most often nowadays is not working. So you go for Venco, and against Venco also they have made VRE. And VRE resistance, it happening because of the alteration in the cell wall structure. That you remember, D-alanine, D-alanine leads to D-alanine, D-lactate or D-alanine, D-serine variations. Okay, and this bile alkaline agar is the culture media for this particular fellow. Bile alkaline agar is the culture media on which the black colored colonies they come, and when you go for the gram staining of it, then what you observe violet color gram positive cocci. Okay, violet color, but they will be violet colored, right? So this is regarding the Enterococcus faecalis. All the following mycobacteria, they produce pigment except, that is the Kansa C, Simi, Avium or Scrofulacium. So all the following mycobacteria produces pigment except. The answer to this question is Avium, that is Mycobacterium Avium. Fine. Why? Because the photochromogens, as the name suggests, they produce the pigmentation in the presence of light, and scotochromogens, they produce in the darkness. So these fellows, they produce the pigment. Non-chromogens, they don't do that, and the rapid growth, they don't do that. What is the classification? The classification is Runyon's. The classification for this is what? That is the Runyon's classification. And what is there in the Runyon's classification? The photochromogens, scotochromogens, anion chromogens, and rapid growers. So that is the first of all, you take the photochromogens, and in the photochromogens, what comes? In the photochromogens comes mask. Okay. In the photochromogens, what comes? That is the mask. And what is there in the mask? M is Marinum, A is Asiaticum, and S is Simi, and K is CC. Okay, so remember, these are the names of the photochromogens which loves to grow in the presence of light, that is photochromogens. And the scotochromogens is SSG. S is Zulgai, another S is Scrofulacium, and one is Gardeni. In the non-chromogens, what comes? In the non-chromogens comes the MAC, that is the Avium complex. Then you have Ulcerans and Xenopi, that is Mycobacterium Xenopi. That is also there in the non-chromogens. And the rapid growers, you know, what comes in rapid growers? In the rapid growers comes Chiloni and 48M. Chiloni and 48M, it comes in the rapid growers. Remember guys, one question can come that what is the other name of MAC? The other name is Mycobacterium intracellulare, which is also termed as Batty's bacillus. Okay, which is also termed as MIP, that is Mycobacterium indicus prani, which is a famous scientist, Indian scientist, which have led to a vaccine preparation, MW vaccine. So remember, MW vaccine is preferred from this MIP, which is belonging to this non-chromogen stuff. And the classification name is what? Ronyon. The answer to this question is C. That is the AVF. Okay. Remember, the photochromogens and the scotochromogens, they are pigmented atypical mycobacteria, that you know. And remember one more point, that the Zulgae is a photochromogens at 24 degrees centigrade and scoto at 37. But mainly we take it as scoto at 37. That is SSG. That was the mnemonic for this. Okay. So this particular one marks the end of the Jipmer exam questions. Just give it a view. Okay. And very best of luck for your exam, NEET exam, as well as obviously Jipmer, those who are giving it up. And it will definitely give a boost to your preparation, and might be one or two questions you're getting from this only. Okay. So do hear it out once and discuss it with your friend and all. And very best of luck. Okay. So, kaabile tareef hone ke liye waqif e takleef hona padta hai. To ho jaiye thode din. And very best of luck. See you. Thank you.